For the past 7 months, we've been fighting this horrible virus known as COVID-19. And like you, I am sick of it. Unfortunately, we're not done with COVID-19, and it's not done with us. Every time we make some progress toward either figuring out how to minimize its impact on individuals, businesses, and activities, or how to limit its spread, somehow impacts on our residents and businesses in ways that we could not have imagined return. And sometimes Mother Nature creeps up and takes sides. With cold weather coming, Mother Nature is about to side with COVID. We need to keep fighting and be creative in doing it. Many of our restaurant and retail stores have gradually figured out ways to fight back. We have adopted with outdoor dining, delivery, and curbside pickup. Parking lots have become socially distant, tented dining rooms. Menus have gone from design printed documents to lists we are reading through QR codes on our phones. We continue to stress that no matter how creative we get in gradually reopening our county, nothing is as important as following the safety guidelines of wearing masks, keeping social distances, and washing hands whenever possible. I have heard several of the top medical professionals in our nation respond whether they think universal wearing of masks or a vaccine will be more important in getting control of the virus, and just about every one of them says a mask. We need to listen to the opinions of people with medical and research degrees. After some progress in keeping the infection numbers down in our county, our rates are inching up again, like much of the nation. We will closely monitor the factors that are producing those increases. Contact tracing is showing us that gatherings of people, even in family settings, is leading to the spread of the virus. Winter is coming, and so are the holidays. Gathering outdoors is going to become even more difficult, and holidays are defined by gatherings of families and friends, most likely indoors. We just need to be even more careful. I also want to point out that the CDC has revised its guidelines. As of a couple of days ago, we were talking about maintaining 6 foot of distance between people as an adequate barrier when you're wearing a mask. Now, with the confirmation that COVID is spread by the virus being present in the room, within the air within a room, we have to be even more careful than before. Despite the creativity of many of our businesses, they need more help. We continue to make the county reopen Montgomery grants of up to $5,000 available to businesses for expenses they incur related to the COVID era. This week, we have partnered with the Montgomery County Economic Development Corporation and some private partners to launch the 3R initiative that could provide up to $5,000 more to qualifying restaurants and retail establishments. Eligible businesses must apply by November 5th to earn those grants. We know these grants are not saviors, but we also know they can really make a difference for some businesses. More information on the 3R grants are available at the address you will see on your screen. Other solutions to fight the impact of COVID-19 make us more aware of the unforeseen damage. One situation is how restaurants and some retail businesses have become dependent on delivery services to keep their names and products viable. But we are learning more and more about how many of these servicers are taking such large cuts of the prices through their fees that our businesses are being further hurt rather than helped. For this reason, I have asked our Office of Consumer Protection and our County Attorney's Office to explore ways that we can control the fees charged by delivery services, especially the large companies that quickly bought up smaller competitors and now dominate the market. I know that some of our restaurants and retailers believe they cannot survive without the delivery services, but unless we get control of these sometimes enormous and exorbitant fees, they may fail to survive because of them. One immediate way you can help your favorite local restaurant is to order your meals to be picked up rather than to be delivered. This would go a long way toward making sure those restaurants earn a decent profit during these hard times. They've already lost customers. Losing additional money through the delivery fees is certainly going to be a severe hit for these restaurants. Speaking of delivery, many of you may have received the ballots you requested by mail. You can drop them in a mailbox, or you can take them to one of the secure ballot drop boxes we have around the county. With Election Day less than 2 weeks away, it is now too late to request a vote-by-mail ballot, but you can still avoid the potentially long lines at voting centers by voting early. There will be 11 early voting centers in the county. They will be open starting Monday, October 26th, and they will remain open until Monday, November 2nd. Strongly consider voting early. Whether you are out to vote or starting your holiday shopping, please remember the safety guidelines during this health crisis. We want all of you to stay safe.